Hello my friends, Rune here again. In today's video, I want to try out my Umarex PPQ M2. It's a 43 caliber or 11mm paintball pistol. Black version. Excellent sights. And it has relatively good accuracy. So, in my last video, I think it was, I put in a softer valve spring. So, but it didn't do much for velocity as I can remember. But I will do another test today. I will try it out with aluminium balls from Home Defense 24. 1.8 gram. I have Umarex power balls, the blue rubber type. These are 1.35 gram. And I have the Rap4 or Crap4. Their ammo is actually quite good. These are hard plastic balls. They are 24 grain. About the same weight as the Powerball, I think it was. And I also have black rubber balls. We can try. Plus, I also have some powder balls. So, targets in my video today will be a beer can. We can try shooting at the bottom. It is relatively stiff. If you ever shot at this with soft guns, you know that the bottom part is relatively difficult to make holes in. And I have a stack of cardboard. It is about 4 centimeters thick. So you can see which one of the bolts that will penetrate deepest or penetrate the whole bunch. I guess they will shoot through it, all of them, but I don't know for sure. So, in order to load it up, we need to slide the bottom part, the cover, a bit forward. And I use my own long 6mm hex wrench, which was a gift from a friend some years ago. You can of course use the one that sits inside the grip here, you have one there. But because of my shitty, crappy arthritic fingers, and I have prosthetic joints and arthrodesis, that means I cannot move my wrist. I have a metal bar sitting in here, plus some metal cramps, etc. So, yeah. I struggle, to say at least. But this is what I think is fun, so... This is my great hobby. I've been shooting all my life since I started with guns back in 1977 or whatever it was. So, Crossman Pelican Oil, Umarex CO2 canister. Let me put it in there, like so. Let's see if it holds gas. It sure does. So, load it up with balls. You pull down the magazine follower, hook it in place down there, and then you can put in 8 balls into the hole in the top there. You don't have to see me do that. So, let's... step into my shooting range, aka my bedroom, and see what sort of power it gives and what sort of items it makes holes in. Unfortunately, I don't have any tin cans. Yeah. So, shout out to Less Lethal Armored Force. While I remember it? Yes. Okay, one moment.
Okay, inside my bedroom, aka my shooting range. Putting up some cardboard. And cocking the action. First four shots will be aluminium and then the power balls. Room temperature is around 22 degrees Celsius. So let's see how it goes. .315. And it did not penetrate. No holes in the back there. Let's see if I can use my normal trigger finger holding the pistol sideways. Dropping a bit, 296. Still no penetration. .289 .272 So that was the four shots here. None of them went through. Let me shoot the next to it. It is the power balls. .303 And it did not penetrate either. I can see it down there. But we can measure the depth later. .297 .291 It should be one more. .287 And one of them went through. Let me do a little reload. So first up is the wrap 4 and then quick access balls. So .292 and in there and nothing out the back. .288 .281 .278 And nothing out the back. Next four is the quick access balls. These are lighter so they fly faster. .332 .326 .324
And there should be one more.
.321. And none of them went through either.
So, and why wouldn't it lock back? No, it did it. Yes. Let me load up with rubber balls. We can see how that works. And now load it up with the rubber balls. These are 14.4 grain. .309. .308. At least it's stable. .300. Let's take one more. .297. Here you can see the balls, they are sitting almost flush into the cardboard there, so of course no penetration. Let's see what it do to a beer can. .298. In there, out there. Let's see if it will go through the bottom. I just pinch it.
Just a dent.
There's the ball. Let's make some more holes in the side of the beer can.
.297.
.294. And I think it is one more.
Let's try with just one shot
of the with the wrap for the hard plastic balls. Let's see if that will penetrate the bottom of the tin can. Sorry, pop can. I think I'll just poke it into my trap there.
There you go. If you're using the hard plastic ammo or aluminium, then it will shoot a hole in the bottom. But the softer rubber balls, they struggle. Yeah.
So, with these shots and the five shots, I think it was six on this. I dry fired it 9 more times, and that is a total of about 34 shots fired totally, and then it wouldn't recock. The last 9 shots was just dry firing. So before I put in the softer valve spring, I got around 50-55 shots, between 50 and 60 shots from one set of canister. So it's at least 15 shots less now compared to what it was before I changed the spring. So yeah, let me just a small hiss. By the way, it's a 6mm Allen key or hex wrench. So yeah. The trigger has improved a lot since I first got the pistol. So much better trigger now. I can actually use my normal trigger finger when shooting. So, but let's see the, what sort of penetration we got. Okay, for sure. And here you can see the rubber. Bottom part is not penetrated, so I'll move that aside. But it would still hurt quite a bit being shot with these black rubber balls, even though these are the ones that didn't penetrate as deep. So, as I suspected, aluminium balls penetrate the most, but only by a fraction. These here are where the aluminium balls almost made it out. They may also made a crack in the lower part here. So, plus this one. So they're shot almost through the whole thing. It lacked only the last centimeter. So it almost went through 3 centimeters of cardboard. And the wrap 4 was second best, and then the quick access balls, which was almost as deep, even though I shot them at the almost last of the CO2 canister. So if I put them in and shot them first, then they might have done better. I don't know. But quick access balls are also quite good. Flying fast and good penetration, well, good, relatively speaking, in this modest powered paintball pistols. So yeah, just a quick little test. And of course it shot straight through the beer can, and with a hard ball it shoots a hole in the bottom of the beer can. But not with the rubber balls. The rubber balls are spongy, so they will just bounce back. Yes. Okay. Yes. Stay tuned for more videos. Hope you like this one. Thank you for watching.